The first sort of gang of lads to get out of England and sort of be massively famous and have loads of girls running after him and stuff, of course, was the Beatles, as they're known up here. So I think that kind of encouraged a lot of people, lads all over England, but really encouraged people in the north, I think, young lads from the north, sort of see a way of getting out and making loads of money and being famous and getting loads of attention and getting away from crap jobs, which there were a lot of in those days, not even crap jobs now.
Seem to think that like it's in Liverpool and Manchester. It's never been that. I mean, we've had all that in the past, like going to football matches and things like that. And so as far as we're concerned, that type of thing is dead. And like this Liverpool fighting Manchester thing is only a thing which has been perpetuated by the music press or any press.
Get an interesting story out of it.
To get the thing, if they can say to us, "Do you hate Manchester?" and we go, "Yeah," like that guns and that. You think they can get an interesting story out of it? And that, but I mean, that's not going to happen because, like, as far as we're concerned, we're made up with like. Then what's happening in Manchester?
Manchester et Liverpool, je me revois flânant le long des rues. Au milieu de cette foule, parmi ces milliers d'inconnus.
Là, c'est Marie Laforêt qui chante et Manchester qui joue contre Liverpool et qui rivalise.
Only at football matches if you went to Liverpool, and I wasn't personally involved in any sort of like Liverpool Manchester war or anything else. It was just a matter of which football team you supported. But I dare say there was like plenty of sort of thugs and beating each other up on a Saturday night. It wasn't really that big part of Manchester, was it, Manchester?
No. I mean, I think, you know, it's like Johnny says, it's just a football thing and it's just a few individuals. Like, I go out to Liverpool virtually every Saturday night now that the Hacienda's closed down. And people are great. There's no, I don't get any bad vibes or anything. People are really good. And it'd be mad anyway, we're so close to two cities, it's only 30 miles between the two cities.
You get all this crap about, like, you know, the Beatles, four lads from Liverpool and all this, and we get, like, tagged with that and Merseybeat, and it seems to us like people do want to, like, get this Mersey thing going, like, kind of thing from outside, which can't be a bad thing for the city, like. It seems to us like people do have that attitude about, like, there is something coming from Liverpool. You know what I mean? And we'll go with that. Together in the four-piece band, that's just like guitars and drums. It's the same format, and it's just garage band kind of stuff, innit?
It's all been done before, hasn't it, Rick?
Yeah.
It's all about the 60s. It's before that as well, Rick.
This is right.
There's a lot forgotten about, Rick. Everyone stops at the 60s.
My brave
Paul McCartney bosse aujourd'hui avec un de ses plus anciens admirateurs, Elvis Costello, qui à 11 ans avait sa carte du Beatles Fan Club, et Paul nous pose Elvis.
We've got a lot of things in common because of where we come from.
But he's very good to work with. You know, I think both of us know how to write songs, and we've both got different approaches. So I could take his approach, and then when it got a bit boring for me, I'd say, why don't you change this and change that? And he was very easy. He said, okay, we'll try it. And the same for me, you know, when he thought something I was doing was a bit boring or something, he'd say, let's change that. And so we listened to each other.
If I could find words to tell you I'm sorry, make you understand, I mean just what I say.
Lorsque les Christians enregistrèrent un disque de charité il y a 2 ans avec McCartney, qui vit désormais entre Londres et l'Écosse, ils se sont aperçus que l'ex-Beatle a la nostalgie de Liverpool, comme nous le raconte Gary Christian.
Of course, so you'd be going back to Liverpool now then after. Yeah, there's a kind of look in his eye that is. It's like he really wants to get back to as this guy with all these riches and things, and kind of this strange look in his eyes, like he wished he was back there somehow, you know. I don't know. Maybe I got it wrong, but that's the one I felt, you know. But it was really nice meeting Paul. Liverpool humour is really difficult to understand. Isn't it? Liverpool people are very difficult to understand. Because one minute they can be really aggressive, and the next minute they can be really placid and even funny and wacky, even.
Why is that?
Because I think it could be the Mersey. Something to do with the Mersey.
Rain.